Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we're going to go over a way that you can make graph paper in Excel. We'll do this so that if you want to, you can print the graphing paper. So we have to get a little creative to make graph paper that is printable in Excel, because just adding borders doesn't create a printable sheet. You end up with an error that there's nothing to print. And by the way, if you find this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. The first thing we're going to do is change our view to page layout view. The reason we want page layout for this is to make it easier to resize our cells. So Excel cells are measured in points, and obviously you can calculate what the conversion would be to inches or centimeters, but in page layout view, you don't have to worry about that. In this view, we can resize cells using common types of measurements. And I'm also going to change my margins to 1-inch margins. Next, because again, we can't just add borders, we're going to instead insert a table. So highlight a good portion of your page, and don't worry that it doesn't take up the entire page right now. We're going to fix that in a moment. And here in the Insert tab, select Table, make sure it's not checked that your table has headers, and click OK. Then once your table comes up, we're going to, under the Table Tools, uncheck any selections that are there. And then in your sheet here, we're going to get rid of that top row. So after inserting the table, now we can resize our cells. If you resize the cells before inserting the table, they'll reset after you add the table. So you'll want to make sure to do it in this order. So let's select all of the cells, and with our cursor up here in the column section where the letters are, simply right click and select column width. And notice how this is already set to inches, with the quotation mark for inches, and I'm just going to do quarter inch grid lines. So we'll set that to 0.25, and then we'll bring our cursor over here to where the numbers are on the left, right click and select row height, and to create perfect squares, I'm also going to set this to 0.25 inches. And now we can make sure that our table takes up the whole page. You can kind of see the outline of it here where it ends. So we scroll to the bottom of it, and where we see this tiny little triangle, we'll just drag this over to the left of the page, and then we'll drag it down to the bottom of the page. So now that our table is covering the entire page, I want to add a little more authenticity. So under the Table Tools Design, I'm going to choose this design with all grid lines in blue. And you see how that made all the grid lines just a little bit of darker blue. And the cool thing about this graphing paper is that you can insert shapes if you like. If you have a touchscreen, you can draw directly on it. You can also print this. And this time we actually have a graphing paper sheet that we can print out. Or you could save it as a PDF, create a template if you want to reuse the same design the next time you need a sheet or a few sheets of graphing paper. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to make graph paper in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.